Good evening, everybody. In this video, we're going to talk about femininity and women. I will not use many sounds in this video. It's going to be mostly just my voice. Hope you will find it relaxing as well as informative. So, we will start with brushing our hair, because it is one of the most feminine traits. I have this wonderful wooden brush that I used in many of my videos. There are no defining characteristics of femininity. However, there are some universal patterns that exist, and that describe femininity to the most, to the fullest, sorry. And those are such traits as gentleness, empathy, sensitivity, caring, nurturance, tolerance, compassion, caring, defense, softness. However, for me, femininity is always something to do with softness and confidence. That is something that you can develop throughout your life by adopting certain habits and changing maybe your presence about yourself. I'm going to put my hair up. In different cultures, femininity is presented by different ideals. It always depends on the culture and the country itself. For example, in Western countries, an image of a woman with flowing hair, with flowing long hair, narrow waist, light skin, facial hair is an image of femininity, when in different cultures, women adapt. They go to extremes such as body alterations. For example, in China, it has been considered to be a very feminine trait when a woman would have smaller feet, so foot binding and tightening, even though it was very difficult and painful, was one of the things that women had to do in order to be more attractive and have more feminine features to them. In Africa and Asia, women use neck rings in order to elongate their necks to have a longer, leaner neck, because it is one of the ideals of a beauty of a woman and therefore femininity. In Indo-European countries, after some studies, the most percentage of men were interested in women with hourglass figure, which is actually a subconscious choice, simply because women with more curves, with more of an hourglass figure, have higher levels of certain feminine hormones, female hormones, that make them more fertile. So males are simply looking for a better mate for themselves, and that's when multi-million industry steps in of making women be more feminine, more curvaceous to attract more males. In the history, types of femininity have been changing a lot. For example, in 16th century in France, wearing high heels was considered a very masculine type of a shoe, when nowadays it's obviously a woman's trait to wear high heels. Then in Egypt and in Persia, beaded dresses were worn, mostly considered female clothing. However, different types of cosmetics and jewelry and wraparound dresses were, and perfumes were worn by both men and women. So it differs with ages. Nowadays, there are no actual idols of beauty or women's beauty or femininity in this world. However, in 1959, a Barbie doll was introduced as a feminine ideal of aesthetic beauty. It has never been accepted by every culture. For example, China has rejected the image of femininity that Barbie represents. Feminists and other organizations also declined and also rejected that image of being a true ideal image of femininity. For example, in Iran, the feminine ideals and dependent lifestyle that Barbie carries is actually a threat to Iranian values, even more in a more harmful way than American missiles are. So it always differs from culture to culture, but in the end, it's all about a woman being kind and sweet and nurturing. Just have that little smile on their face, being more gentle and more understanding to men simply makes you more attractive to a male species. So it's about finding your best features, about the way you treat yourself and things around you and people around you. If you're kind and sweet, if you are gentle with things around you, if you choose to have a more flowing way about you, if you choose to use your body language not in a seductive, any trashy way, no, in a more confident but soft way, that will attract some more people. Obviously, it has to be flowing. It cannot be pressured or fake. But femininity is something that you can adapt over time. So, I thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I wish you a good night.